Magnetic field due to a current carrying solenoid is our topic today. So here we have a solenoid. What is solenoid? Solenoid means it is a current carrying conductor or a conductor in the shape of a spring. A spring which is longer. Okay, along the length we can consider. If you wind a copper wire over this like this, very close turns, insulated copper wire, we can make many rings. That arrangement is called a solenoid. Okay, so I'll draw the shape of a solenoid. Solenoid means copper wire which we are winding in the shape of a spring. There are many rings of the solenoid. The rings are very close together, close to each other. And the wire will be insulated. Insulated copper wire we will use for winding around a cylinder. Okay, so here we can see the diagram. Suppose we have a solenoid like this. We have a solenoid. This is first turn of the solenoid. Then we have the second turn like that. So closely spaced turns are there. There are large number of turns. Okay, let us stop here. And this is a solenoid. One end of the solenoid is connected to positive terminal of the battery and other end is connected to negative terminal. Okay, now and we have learned in lower classes that a current carrying solenoid is behaving like a bar magnet. So one end of the solenoid will be north pole, other end will be south pole. Let us assume that this end is north pole and this is south pole. So externally there is magnetic field from north to south like this. Internally directional magnetic field is south to north. So we will consider magnetic field. These are the magnetic field lines. These are the magnetic field lines due to the current carrying solenoid. Okay, we can find many magnetic field lines. Inside the magnetic field lines are uniform. There we can find many parallel lines. Magnetic field is uniform. Okay, so this is south pole and this end is north pole. And outside also we can represent. Outside it will bend like this. The magnetic field will bend like this. This will be the shape of magnetic field line. Here also we can find the magnetic field line like this. Externally north to south. Okay, so what is our aim? We need to find the magnetic field due to the solenoid at a particular point. We will choose a point within the solenoid. Suppose this be the point. We will choose a point here. Let P be the point. I will mark the point P. At this point P, I need to find the magnetic field. Value of the magnetic field. Strength of magnetic field we need to evaluate. We need to get an equation. So what we will do? We will apply Ampere's law. Before applying Ampere's law, what we need? We need a closed path. That closed path is called a Ampere's loop. Now, first of all, let us describe the solenoid. Let n be, small n be, the number of turns per unit length. What is number of turns per unit length? For example, if the length of the solenoid is 5 meters and if there are 1000 turns in 5 meter, how many turns are there in 1 meter? In 1 meter, there will be 1000 by 5, that is 200 turns. Okay, so there will be 200 turns in 1 meter. In 5 meter, 1000 turns, then 1 meter, 200 turns. So, the number of turns per unit length is the known quantity for us. So, n we are knowing. N is number of turns per length. That is called, it has got one more name, turn density. You can say it is turn density. What is turn density? The number of turns per unit length. Okay. Now, we need to find the magnetic field at this point, P. What we will do? We will assume a closed path. So a symmetrical path we can consider. We can consider a closed path, that is a rectangle we can consider here. A rectangular Ampere's loop we can consider. This is our rectangular Ampere's loop we are considering. Okay. This is our rectangle Ampere's loop. Let us give a name also for the loop. P, Q, R, then S. Okay. This point I will give P1. At this point P1 we are finding the magnetic field. So which are the corners of the Ampere loop? P, Q, R, S. And for the side PQ, let the length be H. H be the length of the side. Okay. So we have how many sides are P, Q, R and S? Four sides are there. PQ is one side, QR is other side, RS is other side and PS is the other side. There are four sides. Okay. So, what is the direction of magnetic field from south to north? Internally. This is the direction of magnetic field. Okay. Now what we will do is, what we are going to do is we need to apply Ampere's circuit law. So what is Ampere's circuit law? According to Ampere's circuit law, we know that line integral of magnetic field along the closed path. What is our closed path? From P, Q, R, S. Closed path is rectangle. We can say P, Q, R, S. We are having the closed path P, Q, R, S, the rectangle B dot DL. Okay, we need to integrate this. Okay, it is equal to mu 0 times current enclosed. Let I be the current enclosed. Okay, now we need to evaluate this. So for the evaluation, PQRS is the closed path. We will split into four lines. PQ is one line. We will integrate along PQ, then along QR, along RS, along SP. So we will split this integration. See how we are splitting this integration. We will split this. So I will write like this. Line integral, closed line integral PQRS B dot DL. How I am splitting? See, I am splitting like this. First line I am taking, first length I am taking P to Q. So I will take P to Q B dot DL. Okay. It is not closed, it is along a length. So no need of symbol closed. Next line integral is, so P to Q, Q to R. From Q to R, again we have B dot DL. B dot DL plus next is R to S. We have next integral R to S B dot DL. Plus, and what about the last one? Last one is S to P. S to P B dot DL. It should be equal to mu 0 times current enclosed. We need the current enclosed. We need a current enclosed within this region. We need not find the current enclosed in this region. This current in this region is outside the loop. Current in this region outside the loop. We need to find the current only within the loop. So, in each turn, there will be current having a magnitude I. Okay. If capital I is the current, in each turn, there is current of magnitude I. We need a current enclosed within this region. So, in each turn, there is current I. Each turn, current is I. How many turns are there within this loop? H is the length. N is the number of turns per length. So, in a length H, how many turns are there? N into H. N into H is the number of turns within the Amperean loop, N into H. One turn carries current I. Second turn, again I. Two turns, 2I. Three turns, 3 into I. Now, how many turns are there, total turns? Total turns here, we will say total turns within the loop. Within the loop is equal to what we have calculated, it is N into H. So, in one turn, how much current? I current. Two turns, 2i. In nh turn, how much current? Nh into I. If I is a current carried, I will write mu 0 times nh into I. Okay. I will use capital I. Nh into I. This is a current enclosed. This is a current enclosed by the Ampere loop. Okay. So, right side is over. We need to evaluate this left side. Now, see B dot DL. P to Q. P to Q. Okay. This is the length. Okay. But there's one problem outside the solenoid. This is the interior part of solenoid. Outside solenoid, magnetic field is not uniform and it shrunk this weak also. Lines are not closely spaced. So it shrunk this very, very weak. Now we can neglect this B outside. Okay. So when you neglect this weak field outside, what we will get? This result will be zero. Why? We are neglecting the magnetic field outside the solenoid because it is very weak field outside. Okay. Next one, we'll take Q to R. What about Q to R? From Q to R, if we take a small element, this element is having this direction. This is the element. What about the magnetic field? Magnetic field is rightward horizontally. Okay. This is the direction of magnetic field, B. Okay, inside. So, what is the angle between these two? 90 degree. The element makes an angle 90 degree with the magnetic field. So, what we'll write here? We'll write here integral Q to R. B dot DL. What we will write? B DL cos 90. What about cos 90? Cos 90 will be 0. So this term also will be 0. Now, third side. Third side integral R to S. B dot DL. R to S. So, here the length of the element and magnetic field are parallel. This is the magnetic field and length of the element also in same direction, same length. Okay, there is zero angle between them. What we can write? We can write B into dl into cos 0. Cos 0 means angle between magnetic field and element is 0. Now, the fourth step, S to P. We will write S to P. We have B dot dl. How will you write B dot dl? S to P. The element is vertical. Magnetic field is horizontal. What is the angle between them? Again, 90 degree, just similar to this. So, what we will write? B dl into cos 90. Okay. So, we know cos 90 values are 0. So, what is the net value? Net value when you write, it will be like this. We will write the net value. Okay. This will be 0. This also 0. I will write first 0, 0 plus this also 0. Third, we have a value R to S B into dl into what is cos 0? Cos 0 is 1. So, B into dl plus what about last one? Last one is cos 90, it will be 0. So, we can write to 0 there plus 0. And what about the right side? The right side is like total integral is equal to mu 0 times nhi. We will write mu 0 times nhi. Okay. Now, integral R to S. B is constant. At each and every point, B is uniform. Take it outside. B integral dl from where to where? R to S. It is equal to mu 0 nhi. Integral dl from R to S. From R to S. Integral dl. We need to integrate. We need to add these dl lengths. What will be the length from here to here? It will be equal to the length of the side. What is the length of the side? PQ or R? It is H. So what is integral dl? It will be equal to H. So we'll write next step here. B into what is this integral? It is equal to H. Is equal to right side. What we have? We have right side mu 0 nhi. H cancels. What is left? B is equal to mu 0 ni. This is our resultant equation. So, the magnetic field due to the solenoid at interior point will be equal to mu 0 n into I. Okay. So, this is our derivation. So, here we have applied Ampere's law. We had a closed path Amperean loop. We have splitted the path into four regions. Okay. First region P to Q along the length. Then Q to R. R to S and S to P. Then we have summed up. While summing up, three integrations will be 0. These two are 0 because the angle between the element and the magnetic field are 90 degrees here and here. That's why it is 0. Here it is 0 because outside the solenoid, magnetic field is very weak. We can neglect. Okay. Now I'll tell you about one more thing I'll tell you. North and south pole. Okay. Now, suppose actually, the solenoid we are winding in a circular shape. Along a cylinder we are winding. When you look at both sides, when you look through this side and through this side. Okay, when you look at this side, we can see the circular shape. Okay, on the cylinder we are winding. The side view. And what about this side view? Here we have a north pole. And how will you express this? We can write the north like this. North. Okay, here south pole. We can write the south like this with arrow marks. What is the meaning of this? When you look from this side, current is flowing in this direction. What is this direction? North. This is the direction. This direction is anti-clockwise. When you look from the other side, current is flowing in this direction. This is the direction. What about this direction? This will be clockwise. This is clockwise and this is anti-clockwise. So when you look at the current from that side, sideways, if this is a solenoid, if you look from that side, it current will be flowing in anti-clockwise direction. When you look from this side, current will be flowing in clockwise direction and vice versa. When the direction of current reverses, here will be south pole and here will be north pole and so on. Okay, I hope that you have understood. We have got a magnetic field due to current carrying solenoid. What is N? N indicate number of turns per length. Okay, so B is proportional to number of turns per length and strength of the current. Okay, thank you.